Well, if I'm a student of class 12th and I've started my preparation for 12 boards, I would plan up my day. The first task being planning your day. I'll take up a diary, note down the subjects I'm gonna do, and yes, I'll include English also. Because in ISC boards, you never know how bad will you score in English, right? So it is mandatory for you to practice English every day. Be it language part or literature part, you have to complete your Tempest also. For Tempest, I would say you can watch the movies. There is a clip on YouTube. I used to watch that, and from that you can get an idea of the story, the outline of the story, and then you will learn the characters. Which characters are there? You'll also come to know about the character sketch of different characters in the play. Right? It's like that. Second thing I would do is write the subject and then the chapter and which exercise I have to complete. For example, I take up mathematics. I want to complete the chapter functions. I'll write mathematics and then functions. And please don't procrastinate. It's a very bad habit and it may end up in bad results. If you start procrastinating, you'll be like very chilled out. And at the end of the day, you'll come to know that you did not even study. You hardly studied for around 3 hours. It's enough if you study for 7 to 8 hours a day. You can plan your day accordingly to which subject you're gonna study. For English, I would say please practice your answer writing. That 15 marks long answer matters a lot. And language, I used to make a lot of mistakes in the prepositions part because it's like what the answer will be. But practicing a lot helped me in increasing my score. Okay, so you have to practice a lot for prepositions, transformation of sentences, and phrasal verbs. Now, for mathematics, I would say you must make a formula notebook because I made that. I made up a formula notebook and noted down all the formulas, whatever chapter I did. For example, I have to start with differentiation today. I'll be noting down the formulas first, learning them, and then starting with the exercises. There is no point of copying the formulas and then solving. There is no point, right? It's gonna be just a wastage of time. So please learn the formulas and then start with the exercise. For physics, also make a formula notebook and a numericals notebook as well. You may practice the numericals. Numericals, you don't have to do a very high level in case you're not preparing for JEE. And you can expect very easy numericals from boards, but you never know what kind of questions can be framed, so be ready for everything. Now the next thing, chemistry. For chemistry, you have to make notes and you need to be very consistent about it. If you are making notes from school or maybe tuition, your notes should be effective. That is, you should understand what's there in the notebook. Do you actually know what is the meaning of notes? It's just a comprehensive form that you have to read and then you can easily interpret, right? What I did was I used to, like, for example, I take up a chapter, I read that chapter one time. You don't have to make notes right now. Read it two times or maybe three times if you get time for that. Then start making notes. Like, you all get notes provided from your tuitions and assignments are there, so it helps you a lot. In case you are not going to tuitions, then you have to make your own notes. Okay, there are some days when you feel like you don't want to study, you feel lazy, and this pandemic has created a very negative impact among the students. They are like, "Kya hoga padh ke?" But aise nahi hai, theek hai? You have to continue your study, kyunki ye kaam aayegi in your entire life. And for 12th, I would say, in case you are a student who is dreaming for any university, prestigious university, so you have to aim above 95%. For example, for Delhi University, for foreign colleges, if you are a student who wants to go to foreign universities, then you have to score well. Apart from that, how to manage your competitive examination preparation and your board examination preparation. For that, you have to make a choice to what are you inclined more. If you are more inquisitive about cracking the competitive examination, I think you should focus on that. And side by side, you should also do your 12th class syllabus, right? Because there is a common portion in both the cases. Like, for example, JEE, physics, chemistry, maths is common in both the cases. But it's like for JEE, it's advanced level, right? Understanding my point. Now, for English and optional subject, I told you English, you have to prepare it. Now, for answer writing portion, you have to include your quotes, कोड्स, हाउ विल यू नो अबाउट वट इज़ कोड एंड वट इज़ नॉट, योर टीचर विल ऑल्सो मेक यू मार्क. और इफ़ यू फील लाइक दैट यू डोंट नो वट कोड्स आर, प्लीज़ कमेंट, आई डेफिनेटली मेक अ वीडियो, अ सेपरेट वीडियो फॉर दैट. एंड हाउ टू राइट 15 मार्क्स लॉन्ग आंसर, आई ऑल्सो पोस्टेड अ वीडियो, मेक श्योर टू चेक इट. हाउ टू मैनेज योर ऑप्शन सब्जेक्ट फॉर कंप्यूटर्स और आर्ट, साइकोलॉजी, देर आर मेनी सब्जेक्ट्स, राइट? एटलीस्ट ट्राई टू गिव 1 hour इन अ डे टू दैट सब्जेक्ट. If you are taking tuition for that, well and good. But keep on revising. Please don't think that it doesn't matter. Everyone scores well. Okay, it's a myth. Everyone has to study each and every subject in order to score exceptional in all the subjects. And yes, your 12th marks, your 12th percentage, it matters a lot. Right? It may not matter for when you are giving competitive examinations, but still, for your jobs, or if you are applying for universities, then also it matters. Talking about reference books, as such, you don't have to buy the reference books. You can buy 10 years afterwards when you complete with your syllabus. For example, mathematics, the best book is S. Chand. For physics, chemistry, it's Newton. Please stick to these books. Don't try out new books. It is just a wastage of money, okay? So try to cover your own book. Don't jump to various sources. It will make you more confused. Rather, it may demotivate you. So it's better to stick to your book. And if you feel that any thing is missed out in this video, make sure to comment. And I also upload chapters on mathematics. I'll be uploading more chapters. So any problem, any doubt, you may ask me. I've also attached the link of the group, Telegram group of AB Education Hub. You can join. I'll update you with all the CISC news. And I sometimes post practice papers also, so that you can practice, for example, of different schools, the pre-board papers of different schools. Initially, you are starting with the preparation. I'll be providing you the sample papers like 2 months before the board examination they start, right? So I think that was all for the video. Thank you for watching. If you liked this, make sure to give it a thumbs up and do subscribe my channel.